السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. حضرت مسیح موعود علیہ السلام فرماتے ہیں کہ یاد رکھو کہ انسان کو چاہیے کہ ہر وقت
The promised Messiah, peace be upon him, says, Remember, man should remain in constant supplication and prayer at every moment and circumstance. Secondly, he should act upon Amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith and the bounty of thy Lord proclaim and constantly remind himself of the favors of God the Almighty. This increases love of God and instills a passion within to submit to and obey Him. Indeed, we are witness to the divine favors and bounties on a daily basis. And this should increase our love of God and attention to proclaiming His blessings. However, when I am on tour, the bounties of God increase manifold. Allah infuses His blessings into the various programs, conveys the message of Islam to many more people than normal, and He causes the hearts of people to be stirred. I was recently on a tour of Germany, and although the main purpose was to attend the Jalsa, God created various means to spread the message of Islam to people and introduce its reality to them. As mentioned, the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, said that man should remain constantly engaged in prayer and supplication in all circumstances and at every moment. Most certainly, we would be unable to progress even an inch without prayers. We should always pray sincerely, and may Allah the Almighty enable us to pray with due justice. When, along with prayers, we witness the bounties of God descending many times more than our meager efforts, when we witness God manifesting His attributes in different ways, it also becomes necessary to constantly remember God's favors on us and to relate them. This then infuses love of God into the hearts of the mu'mineen, the true believers. It also stirs passion in their hearts towards submitting and obeying God. Which in turn attracts further blessings and bounties of God. And so God's favors descended on the Germany Jalsa and the other programs during the tour. And the message of Islam Ahmadiyya was disseminated on a very large scale and widespread in the country. This should incite us to proclaiming God's bounties. And the Germany Jamaat should especially be extremely grateful for the blessings showered by God during these days. This gratitude should lead them to submitting to God in humility so that God increases His favors on us. We cannot affect the hearts of others without the grace of God. Unless God wills, man cannot move the hearts of others. One may try 100,000 times, but will fail to effectively convey his message, unless God desires for it to do so. Sometimes a passionate speech does not inspire others, whereas a simple speech, delivered in a moderate tone, does. This is what we experience during the Jalsa. The non-Muslims in attendance express their feelings, and I will briefly mention some of these at this time. With the grace of Allah the Almighty, many people came to the Germany Jalsa from Eastern Europe and neighboring countries. Many non-Ahmadi and non-Muslims also came to the Jalsa through their acquaintances with Ahmadis. They came to learn the truth and often are so inspired by the servants of the Imam of the time that they decided to join the community and take the bayat, the oath of allegiance. This year also, delegations were in attendance from Macedonia, Bosnia, Kosovo, Montenegro, Bulgaria, Albania, Russia, Hungary, Lithuania, Croatia, and Slovenia. New Ahmadis as well as non-Ahmadis also participated from neighboring European countries including Belgium, Holland, France, Sweden, Spain, and Italy. Similarly, Ahmadis and non-Ahmadis living in Germany, originally from Russia and its former states, and also from Turkey, attended in large numbers. Mulaqats were held with all of these people, and there were question and answer sessions held. I shall present the sentiments expressed by some. 16 people attended from Albania, out of whom 2 took the bayat, the oath of allegiance, after listening to the Jalsa proceedings. A person named Erva Jepa Sahib participated with his wife, both of whom are in the field of law. He is an Ahmadi. However, his wife took bayat after participating in the Jalsa and after mulaqat. Alhamdulillah, all praise belongs to Allah. She remarked that her experience at the Jalsa was extraordinary, where she witnessed love, sincerity, and selfless service and devotion. This, she said, had deeply touched her heart. She relates that her husband, who is also a lawyer like her, had been preaching to her for some time. The beauty of Ahmadiyyat was embedded in her heart as a result. However, she had now accepted Ahmadiyyat with full conviction. this lady was crying throughout her mulaqat. She is not elderly, rather is quite young. As such, there is a great heed among the youth towards recognizing the reality of Islam. Another person, Ibrahim Durshila Sahib, announced during mulaqat that he had accepted Ahmadiyyat and taken the bayat to join. He says that although I had greatly delayed taking this step, today I joined Ahmadiyyat with full conviction and I am absolutely sure I made the correct decision. Another person, Argun Sahib, said that he attended the Jalsa Salana last year. However, he noticed an exceptional improvement and enlargement in the arrangements at this year's Jalsa. In short, these improvements and increased scale of the Jalsa are all due to the grace of Allah. This is something that should lead the administration to becoming even more grateful to God. A 62-person delegation attended the Jalsa from Macedonia, among whom were 14 Christians and approximately 27 were non-Ahmadi Muslims. They reached after a long, roughly 2,000 kilometers, 36-hour journey. Two among them were journalists who filmed various scenes at the Jalsa. They also recorded interviews and afterwards said that upon their return, they will produce a TV program for broadcast. A guest from Macedonia said, "After having attended the Jalsa, I am now leaving with its memories. The arrangements of the Jalsa were so expansive that any organization would barely be able to perform them. In fact, I would say that even a large country would not be able to organize a program of this standard." Another gentleman from Macedonia said, "It is the first time I have met such nice people. What has impressed me the most is the message of Islam which I have received from here. The messages that you have displayed on the walls are not limited to just text. In fact, you put them into practice. This has had a profound effect upon my heart." Then Tony Sahib, a guest from Macedonia, said, "As a journalist, I have participated in many programs around the world. However, this was better than all of them. Everything had been very nicely organized and there was discipline too. What impressed me the most was that everyone is equal in the sight of God. Every member had patience and there were no disputes amongst each other due to difference of faith, nation and language. As a non-Muslim, this is a matter of great significance for me." Another guest from Macedonia said, "This is the first time I have attended the Jalsa Salana. Everything was new to me, and I never knew that such a community exists in Islam. After having attended this Jalsa, I find myself intellectually in a better state. I have acquired more knowledge of Ahmadiyyat and experienced it too. I feel as if I am part of this community. For such a large number of people to gather and then to provide them with their needs is indeed a huge task." He also had the opportunity to meet me and said, "I will ponder over all the things you have said and see what are the differences between us and the Ahmadis." That in fact was his question, that what is the difference between an Ahmadi and a non-Ahmadi. So he said, "I have really liked everything you have said. My message for the community is that you should send your missionaries to my country and also other countries where the community has not been established, and you should tell people about Ahmadiyyat. Such demands are not just the odd case. In fact, they come from many places. A guest from the delegation from Macedonia, Dragan Sahib, said, "It is the first time I have had such a close interaction with Muslims. I have heard speeches regarding the teachings of Islam. The Muslims here have given us such a welcome that it seemed as if they had always known us." A gentleman from Bosnia said that before he never had a strong link with the community, but after having met the head of the Ahmadiyya community, he has undergone an extraordinary change. His respect for the community and particularly Hazrat Khalifatul Masih has increased greatly in his heart. Another friend, Atur Sahib from Sweden, attended with his family. They brought a friend with them who had accepted Ahmadiyyat in 2013, but did not get the opportunity to meet me. After meeting me, he became very passionate and kept expressing that he thought he would not be able to meet me due to the busy schedule, but the opportunity arose and he was in very high spirits. The missionary writes that on the way to the Jalsa, he would ask to stop so that he could stretch his legs and walk, as he suffered from leg pains. However, on the way back, he completed the 17-hour journey without any breaks. After arriving home, when he was asked why he did not stop, he said, "I did not even realize that my legs had any problems because of the blessings of the Jalsa." Then a member of the Croatian delegation, Josipa Saheba, said, "Prior to coming to the Jalsa, I read the present head of the community's book, World Crisis and the Pathway to Peace. I also read Khalifatul Masih's keynote address delivered at the peace symposiums in 2014 and 2015. I had the impression that the leader of the community was strict in certain matters and would have a strict temperament. However, these impressions disappeared after meeting him. She has started to conduct further research into the community." Mazee Sahib from Hungary attended the Jalsa. He has served in different ranks in the police force. He now serves humanity by working in a fund named after the Prime Minister and is Christian by faith. Expressing his emotions, he said, "Everyone, whether big or small, were greeting one another with salam, that is, the greetings of peace, and meeting each other with love. Although I could not understand their language, but their facial expression suggested that they were distributing love. I have travelled the world and never have I seen such scenes anywhere in the world like this one. The Jalsa has had a strange impact upon me. I will certainly tell my friends and family about the Ahmadiyya community's Jalsa." Gabor Peter Sahib, who is also from Hungary and is Jewish by faith. The missionary from there says that before attending the Jalsa, whenever they would speak with regards to Islam and Judaism, he would often become argumentative. Hazur says, "However, since meeting me, he has said, 'You people do not only believe in love for all, hatred for none. In fact, I have observed that you also practice this motto.'" He has now said that whenever the community requires anything in Hungary, he will cooperate with the Jamaat. Thus, these are the changes that God Almighty causes.�
تعلق ویسے بکینہ فاسو سے ہے لیکن انگلینہ مقیم ہے.
Ismail Sahib was part of the delegation from Hungary. He had initial contact from Burkina Faso, but now lives in Hungary. He accepted Ahmadiyyat a short while ago in Hungary alongside his two daughters and wanted to attend with them. His wife is Hungarian and said that she would not allow her daughters to go alone because she did not know what kind of Muslims he was taking them to. Therefore, the grandmother of the daughters also came. The impact of the Jalsa that was bound to have an effect of them indeed did. But it also had a great effect on their grandmother too. She saw the various proceedings of the Jalsa and was shown the video entitled One Community, One Leader. And that too had a great effect upon her. Before entering the Jalsa hall, she said that she has not brought anything with her to cover her head. Therefore, she asked for a head covering from the ladies and covered her head. During their meeting with me, she was very passionate and said, "This is a completely different world that I am witnessing, and all our reservations have gone away." A friend from Germany, Suleiman Sahib, who is from the Central Republic of Africa, says, "I received an invitation for the Jalsa and thought that there would be no more than 50 to 100 people attending the event, in which there will be a small discussion and some food and drink, after which everyone would go home. However, my view has completely changed since coming here. There were people gathered in their thousands, and I just cannot come out of the enchanting experience of the Jalsa. Everything here is mesmerizing, and your method of tabligh or preaching is unique. If they continue to do tabligh in this way, then only a highly unfortunate person can reject it." Raghib Shabtafi Sahib, who came from Montenegro, said, "I heard the speeches, saw the arrangements, and it was an extraordinary event. Raghib Sahib also said, "It is a commonly held belief among the Muslims in Montenegro that, God forbid, the Ahmadiyya community does not accept the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. However, when one closely observes the community, it is immediately evident that this is a complete lie which the Maulvis have circulated." Another friend from Morocco, who now lives in Belgium, says, "I cannot explain my emotions. It was such a spiritual atmosphere that has left an impression to the core of my soul. I have witnessed the true image of Islam here." He also says, "My perception about Ahmadiyyat has completely changed after meeting the Khalifa of the time and listening to his speech. May God enable me to do the bayt, the oath of allegiance, and I become a servant of faith and spread the message of the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, across the world." A German guest, Beko Frankel Sahib, says, "This was the first opportunity for him to learn something about Ahmadiyyat. Hazur says that he then said about me that whatever I have said is the truth, and if all of mankind starts to adhere to this, then peace will establish in the whole world. I have learnt about Islam far more than I expected, and I have sought great pleasure from it." A new convert from France, Hanli Afan Sahib, who lives in Algeria, he did the bet only 3 weeks ago and says, "I was a Muslim, but was not steadfast. Yesterday, after reading the Jummah, the Friday prayer behind Khalifatul Masih, I sought great pleasure and cried for the first time in my prayer. Prior to accepting Ahmadiyyat, all my affairs were in a state of limbo, but ever since I have become Ahmadi, everything has been rectified. I witness the signs of God the Almighty every day. A student, Edgar Oss, says, prior to coming to Jalsa, I had very negative impressions of Islam garnered through the electronic media. But after listening to these speeches and observing the various programs of the Jalsa, I found everything to be so different. Everyone's attitude was so positive, and I am witnessing the true Islam through your image. Similarly, there are many other impressions of people. A lawyer from Lithuania says, I have been greatly impressed after attending the Jalsa. I have listened to the addresses of your Khalifa. It is a new experience for me regarding Islam. Here I have learnt about the reality of the teachings of Islam. I am grateful to you. And as a lawyer, I will fully support you in terms of allowing your legal right to practice in Lithuania. One person from Bosnia said that Khalifatul Masih has presented a clear concept about the living God. It is only the Ahmadiyya Muslim community today which claims that there is a living God and has the ability to prove it as well. You explain this concept to us in a clear manner and in an easily comprehensible language. A Muslim person who lives at the border of Germany and Belgium said that before attending the Jalsa in Germany, he did not take religion and the Jamaat or the community seriously. He said that I had a complete change of heart by attending the Jalsa. The community I never took seriously showed me the best days of my life in the shape of the Jalsa Salana. Then he mentioned a long dream of his. A new German Ahmadi, Patrick, says that today I have the honor of taking the oath of allegiance, the Be'at. What motivated me to do so was the English address of the Khalifatul Masih to the German people. Through Khilafat, I saw genuinely loving Ahmadiyya Muslim community, and my heart is full of love and the light of understanding. A Syrian gentleman, whose father is Ahmadi, used to live in Russia with his father. He is in Holland these days pursuing his studies. His father used to preach to him about the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, but he was convinced enough to take the oath of allegiance. Before the Jalsa, he used to hold question and answer sessions with our missionary every day. Our missionary used to give him proofs regarding the truthfulness of the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, but he was not convinced. At this, our missionary in charge told him to pray. The Syrian gentleman said, I do pray. So our missionary in charge told him that you need to pray with extreme pathos and anguish, that Allah the Exalted grant you the right path. After the second day of Jalsa, I gave an address and held a meeting with the German guests. I do not know if he attended that meeting or not. Anyway, on the day of my address, he said to our missionary that please can you show me just one proof of the truthfulness of the promised Messiah, peace be upon him, from the Holy Quran. The missionary in charge showed him the evidence and also showed him many prophecies. He also explained to him the progress of the Jamaat. The Syrian gentleman said that I wish to take the oath of allegiance now because God has shown me a sign. He said during the night he prayed to God with extreme passion and anguish. he saw in his dream, when he slept at night, that there was a big wall on which the word Al-Ahmadiyya was written in bold letters, and there was exceptionally bright luminous emitting from this. And as I was addressing the German guests, the Syrian gentleman asked for a sign from God and wished that he had an opportunity to stand close to the Khalifatul Masih. After a short while, he felt as if he was dozing off. And then he saw himself standing next to Khalifatul Masih on the stage. This made him appreciate the truth. He said that he asked for evidence from the Holy Quran just to be double sure. However, the truth had been revealed to him with his prayers and his dream. He was fully satisfied, therefore he took the bet, the oath of allegiance. A gentleman from Algeria says that every time I attended the Jalsa, it increases my faith in an exceptional manner. I see the signs of the victory of God in many ways. I feel as if I am in paradise. This is because everybody offers each other the prayers of peace despite coming from different nationalities and speaking different languages. This is what Allah the Exalted has said in the Holy Quran, that believers will offer each other the offering of peace. A Christian delegate from Italy said that he was the general secretary of an organization in Italy called the Religions for Peace. He has significant connection in the Vatican City. He has authored many books on Catholic theology. He seemed to have a good impression about the Jalsa Salana. He wrote an article in his magazine, as when he went back to Italy, this article was read by thousands of people. He says that he wrote in the article that I'll have to accept that the atmosphere of Jalsa was astonishing. When you see written in the bold letter, love for all, hatred for none, then the first question in your mind is, are these people really Muslims? There is no doubt that these people are definitely Muslims. The atmosphere of Jalsa was full of love and unity. I saw with my own eyes that thousands of people belonging to different nations, young, old, children and families, represented an extremely organized community. It impressed me particularly that hundreds of people were working there voluntarily without any reimbursement. The person who used to take me to the Jalsa from my hotel explained to me that he has taken leave without pay for 2 weeks to attend this Jalsa. Hazur says about me, he says that he was impressed with my speeches. He said that his speeches guide one to the right path and that he promotes love, brotherhood, unity and national harmony. Hazur says he also published his detailed article in Italian. A doctor from Syria who attended the Jalsa said that I have never seen such an organized community before. We have a problem organizing 6 people, and here there are nearly 40,000 people, and there is no pushing or shoving going on. I have a deep reverence for the promised Messiah and the Khalifa. I have read the book Barahini Ahmadiyyat, and I swear upon God that in the 19th century, no such book has been written in the defense of Islam, either in the Arab or in any other country. May God enhance his understanding and enable him to accept the truth. With the grace of God, there was an exceptional impact upon others from this Jalsa. I could only mention a very few of these incidences, and only as a very short summary. The blessings of Jalsa are unbelievable. At the same time, some guests have given a positive critique about things we could do differently. Guests generally give their positive feedback, but tend to get embarrassed to mention the things that need improvement. One lady from Albania mentioned that women were wasting pita bread and salan. There are lots of qualities in our ladies, and they should try and overcome this weakness. The organizers in Germany, and in particular Lajna, should raise awareness and encourage those who are eating that they should not waste food. Similarly, a lady coming from Macedonia said that the accommodation was too far, and all this traveling made them tired. So the organization should try and house these guests closer to the Jalsa. Similarly, the officer Jalsa Salana has noted a few things. Indeed, the real progress comes when we note our own shortcomings and try to improve these. It was noticed that people were not focused on cleanliness and threw rubbish anywhere. People should be mindful of that and should try and support each other to maintain cleanliness. Then, regarding what some have said, it is only possible to cook one type of food in the langarkhana. Some people complained about this as they wanted pasta. This shouldn't happen. The real sustenance of Jalsa is the spiritual sustenance. Therefore, Ahmadi should not complain about this and should eat happily whatever is offered to them. This is how we do things. Only one type of food will be cooked. Sometimes the organizers take quite strict stands in some matters, which leads to difficulties to others. They should use their judgment and see if somebody is in real need, and if the need is justified, then they should do their best to help. Sometimes it may mean not strictly adhering to the letters of the rules. All the workers should try to always be kind and do everything for the comfort of their guests. Overall, the organization of the Jalsa was excellent, and this time the officer Jalsa Salana and his team did a much better job than the last few years. When something is organized at such a big level, then few shortcomings are inevitable. These should be addressed. Inshallah, the organization will improve even further next time. May Allah the Exalted reward those workers who worked really hard. On the first day, there were more guests than expected. Therefore, there were some challenges in providing the bedding on the first night. But that was resolved nicely. The problem of last year regarding the sound system and so on have been addressed with the grace of Allah. Just as I always do, I am most grateful to all the workers who served at this Jalsa. During the tour of Germany, along with the Jalsa, I inaugurated some mosques as well. I will briefly mention these. In Aachen, a mosque was inaugurated and a neighbor attended the ceremony. The neighbor said he specifically came to this meeting because he has heard the address of the Khalifa to the European Parliament. He wanted to see if the Khalifa promotes the teaching of peace only in front of important and influential leaders, or he also gives the same message of peace to ordinary people as well. So he came to see if we have double standards. He said, "I heard the address of the Khalifa who has presented exactly the same policy as he presented to the European Parliament." He directed all to promote love for each other, to be kind, to be patient, to show resolve, and to enhance each other with righteousness. All this has really impressed me. Similar sentiments were expressed by the mayor and other people attending. In the province Hessen, a mosque was inaugurated, Baitul Wahid. A member of parliament, who is also district commissioner, expressed his views in his speech. He said that the speech of the Khalifa has left a good impression on us. you addressed the non-Muslim citizens directly and drew their attention that they all belong to one God. Therefore, they should try and be mindful of each other's self-respect and resolve differences by adopting peaceful means. He said that this speech should be available on the internet, and he also requested for the transcript of the speeches. A female German member of parliament said that I am pleased that I am attending the inauguration of this mosque. And before that, I also attended the Florishim Mosque inauguration as well. There are some doubts about the teachings of Islam today. Therefore, it is required that we all work together to promote the message of peace. The inauguration of the mosque of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community here tells us that we all wish to live here with peace, love, and brotherhood. The building of this mosque shows that Germany is the country for Ahmadis. There are many other impressions of people. One guest said that it was difficult for me to have a good impression of Islam. But the picture of Islam that is presented today by the Khalifa has made me see that Islam is a religion of peace and promotes compassion. This concept of Islam is in complete harmony with the teachings of the Holy Quran. One engineer who worked at the building of the mosque said that I agree with everything that the Khalifa has said in his speech. I was expecting this to be like a typical ceremony in a church with lots of pomp and ceremony, but this was a really unpretentious ceremony. There was significant coverage of this tour in the electronic media. Approximately 88 newspapers published news regarding this. The news was broadcast on 8 different radio stations and 4 television channels. Therefore, through newspapers, radio and television, this message reached to 16 to 17 million people. Regarding the Jalsa Salana, Germany, 36 German newspapers reported it, and their collective readership is roughly 32 million. Three different radio stations also relayed the news about the Jalsa, and these are quite famous radio stations. Similarly, different television channels showed programs regarding the Jalsa Salana, and on the last day of Jalsa, a female reporter interviewed me. That interview was to be published in the biggest online newspaper in Germany. Its publication is more than 17.5 million. Therefore, altogether, the message was relayed to approximately 34 million people. Then, regarding the inauguration of mosques, 50 news items were given in the newspapers, and the readership of these newspapers is approximately 62 million. Two radio stations broadcast the news about the inauguration of the mosque, Bayt al-Wahid in Hanau. Along with that, the famous RTL channel of Germany interviewed me at the inauguration ceremony, and a news item of 2 minutes 23 seconds was relayed. Three newspapers of Aachen published the news about this. They have a readership of roughly 1.16 million. A foundation stone for a mosque was laid, and this was mentioned in newspapers with a readership of nearly 6 million. The ceremony of the inauguration of the mosque in Festa and the news was reported in 4 newspapers with a readership of approximately 2.6 million. A newspaper there, the Dayzit, published my interview, and this has a readership of approximately 1.5 million. This is a weekly newspaper which is published every Thursday since 1946 and has 5 million readership online. An Ahmadi journalist took my interview. With the grace of Allah, Ahmadis are also entering the field of media and taking the true message of Islam to the world. May Allah the Exalted grant them knowledge and understanding and blessings. Therefore, the Jalsa is a source for moral and spiritual training for the Ahmadis, and many men and women write letters to me to this effect. At the same time, the Jalsa gives an opportunity to present the true picture of Islam to others. This leads to people taking the oath of allegiance. Many people who, according to the administration, were not ready to take the oath of allegiance were able to do so after meeting me and asking few questions. So how could we possibly be grateful for all the blessings and kindness of God? How can we possibly count all the blessings that God has granted us? May Allah the Exalted enable the community to benefit from these blessings. May these new converts get totally integrated into the community and the blessings of Jalsa, may they keep expanding. May Allah bless all of these people with the benefits of attending the Jalsa, and may He make us truly grateful to Him. After the Friday prayers, I will lead a funeral prayer in absentia of respected Rashida Begum Sahiba, wife of Mr. Muhammadin Sahib Darvish of Qadian. She passed away at the age of 77 on the 1st of June 2015. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. She was from Devar, Karnataka. She got married to one of the 313 Darvish, Mr. Muhammadin. She always advised her children to be pious, righteous, and to have a strong bond of commitment with Khilafat. She was extremely content and faced the destitution of being Darvish and a big family. She always accepted the will of God. She left behind 4 sons and 4 daughters. 2 of her sons are serving the community, Mr. Bashir Ahmad Badr, who serves as the Vice President Amumi and local Murabbi or missionary, and Mr. Tahir Ahmed Badr as Naib Nazir Baitul Mal expenses. One of her son-in-law, Mr. Munir Ahmed Hafiz Abadi, is Vakili Ala Tariqi Jadid, and the other son-in-law is Mr. Shamsuddin, is serving as a Muallim. She was a Musia and was buried in Beheshti Makbara Qadian. May Allah the Exalted treat her with forgiveness and increase her status and grant her the paradise of His approbation. May Allah the Almighty grant her family fortitude and patience and enable them to carry on her virtues.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Nahmadu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر.